I'd never done a posthumous portrait. It began really the family contacted me, sort of, and I think it was their interest in young people and so forth. But anyway, about doing an official portrait of President Kennedy and for the White House. And so I said I would make an attempt. And then after working from photographs and whatnot, I realized that I needed something of life. And so both brothers agreed to let me sort of bird dog them around. At the time, there was campaigns going on, so I went with Teddy around and with Bobby.
When you watched the brothers, Jamie, if I may ask, I mean, what were you looking for?
Well, life. I mean, I just didn't want to work from photographs, and I wanted a living, breathing person. And I'd never met President Kennedy, so I had no memory. So my idea was really to establish a memory of him. I created this portrait, which was alarming to a lot of people, including Bobby, who ended up hating it and said it reminded him of the president during the Bay of Pigs. And
wow.
The one person who really championed it was Jackie and thought it showed a side of the president that few people saw and so forth. Jackie let me see all the films, and she'd taken a lot of photographs of him, of course, and films were almost the most important thing for me. Films taken aboard the Honey Fitz, various things, you know, 8mm films. And I wanted to wade through all the romance, which I felt as much as everybody else did at the time, and try to get a sense of a real human being here who, you know, was cut down and could have gone on to even greater things. And I became completely immersed, completely obsessed with painting this thing. And I did it. I shared a studio with my father, and my father would come through the room I was working, and I had drawings everywhere, on the floor and the ceiling. And out of it came this rather peculiar small portrait, which seems to have some resonance today.
I was always struck from the beginning by that meaty hand JFK is sort of leaning into. And it seemed big for JFK, but it's exactly Teddy's hand.
Yeah, I think it probably is Teddy's hand. But curiously enough, his widow said that that was a gesture he did quite a bit. He'd tap his teeth with his knuckles and whatnot. Mm-hmm. Well, that just sent me over the top. You know, I then sort of built the whole thing around that.
There's something of Hamlet's ghost about it. He is alive from another realm, and he's still saying, what was that? And how did it end?
Yeah, I think it shows a man, an enormously complicated man, who I think still just is fascinating. And, you know, it's not the most beautiful portrait of him. It upset a lot of people. And I mean, I got thousands of letters. I mean, it really was extraordinary. Why do you have this bloated face? Why do you have one eye looking off to the side, one eye looking at you? Why do you have the hand on the mouth? And again, you have to look in the context at that time. President Kennedy was this young, godlike figure who'd been struck down, taken from us. And here comes this 18-year-old boy painting this rather tough portrait of a man, rather blunt. It was a learning experience for me. I'll never do another posthumous portrait. I mean, I was at a thing that somebody who knew him came in and said it doesn't look a thing like him. Well, I couldn't, you know, argue that. But, you know, I think the more you look at President Kennedy's career, the more you see a man who wrestled with huge issues and had an amazing sense of history, and particularly compared to what, you know, we're living through today, it's such a departure.
I read you saying, in effect, that under the portrait of JFK, it's almost a portrait of Lem Billings, a man I knew just slightly, but it was well known in the journalistic world that he was Robert Kennedy's maybe closest friend of all the Robert Kennedy kids, and especially of JFK, that he virtually lived in the White House as a member of the family. I mean, really did live in the White House. What did you learn from Lem Billings?
That was another incredible eye-opener for me. First, he was unquestionably President Kennedy's closest friend from quite young in his youth to the day he died. And to get to know Lem, who was a terribly sweet man, very funny and whatnot, and of course gay. And I thought this flew in the face of everything that I'd read about President Kennedy, which was all his great affairs and all this, which probably existed. And here was this very real person saying, you know, Jack and I would do this, or he brought me into this. It just gave me a whole different perspective on President Kennedy, and that he would have this man around him more than anybody else. Mm. I mean, he was with him constantly.
What part of that, Jamie, is in the painting?
Well, I think it just made him breathe and live and went beyond just me painting a nose and two eyeballs and a shock of hair. It made him of sinew and vessels and bones. It just made him real.
I dreamed I was the president of these United States. I dreamed that I was young and smart, and it was not a waste. I dreamed that there was a point to life and to the human race. I dreamed that I could somehow comprehend that someone shot him in the face.